Now to the latest in Washington. Another 1.2 million Americans applied for first-time unemployment last week. Just look at the number since May. The good news is claims last week fell more than expected, but the numbers are still high.
We're going to go 25 seconds on, 10 seconds off.
Timing is everything. You'll often catch Brian Washington of All City Riders and the Academy gladly breaking a sweat with his workout classes forced to move outdoors during the pandemic. But tonight, as lawmakers in Washington approach a so-called August recess tomorrow without having reached a new coronavirus relief deal, Brian is sweating over his very future.
3, 2, 1. Done.
Yeah, you know, we're in a position now where I stand with the two businesses I have. One is on crutches, and the other, I don't know if we're going to be around in 6 months.
Democrats are demanding money for state and local governments hit hard by COVID-19 and that the supplemental $600 unemployment benefit be extended into next year, especially with the national unemployment rate above 11%. Republicans are offering another round of $1,200 stimulus checks, but pushing to slash the weekly unemployment benefit from $600 to as little as $200, saying if Americans get too much unemployment money, they will not be motivated to go back to work. The deadlock over the extra $600 is threatening the entire economic relief package.
I mean, Schumer doesn't want to do anything, neither does Pelosi.
We believe the patient needs a major operation while Republicans want to apply just a Band-Aid.
And none of them can seem to get together to figure out a way to save small businesses. And the people that are being impacted the most are people who look like me. Minority-owned businesses are going to be the ones that are being hit the hardest.
The Senate announced late tonight they plan to skip their August recess until a bill is passed. But tonight the president is also applying pressure, saying if they don't reach a deal tomorrow, he will take executive action.